$1.3 trillion. That is the current market value of Norway's government pension fund Global. But don't be fooled by the name. It's just a fancy way of saying oil fund, as all of that money comes directly from oil or from investments made with oil money. Now, the fund is actually the largest sovereign wealth fund in the world, ahead of China and Saudi Arabia, which is quite impressive considering the small population size of Norway in comparison to these other oil-rich nations. But unlike these other nations, Norway's oil fund has, under the leadership of Yngve Slyngstad, the previous CEO of the fund, shown increasing willingness to hold companies accountable for social and environmental issues. Those companies include producers of coal or coal-based energy, nuclear weapons manufacturers, producers of tobacco products, and companies that have been shown to violate human rights. Which definitely is a noble thing to do. But last year, on the 26th of March, everything changed, as Norges Bank revealed the new CEO of the oil fund. And that was a problem. You see, a month prior to the press conference, they released a short list of 8 men they would choose the successor from. But the person who appeared on the screen at the press conference was not on the short list of 8 men. Instead, it was a man named Nicolai Tangen. Tangen is the founder of one of Europe's most successful hedge funds, London-based AKO Capital. He has a net worth of approximately $500 million. Tied up in funds and companies based in tax havens, including $31 million in the Russian Property Fund, and $14.1 million in the Ennismore European Small Corporation Companies Hedge Fund, both registered in the Cayman Islands. He also has an ongoing case between his company, AKO Capital, and the British tax authorities, relating to incentive schemes. So, with all of this in mind, it's probably fair to say that Nicolai Tangen didn't really match the path Norway's oil fund was on towards more ethical investments. This is why the Norwegian press swiftly began digging for more information about Tangen and the reason behind his hiring as CEO of Norway's oil fund. And they found something very interesting. At 3 p.m, November 14th, 2019, an all-inclusive trip for some of the most powerful people in the world was scheduled. They were headed to Philadelphia for a weekend-long event that had been several years in the making by its creator, Nicolai Tangen. One of the people who went on this trip was none other than the person who had conveniently just resigned as the CEO of Norway's oil fund just a few days prior to this trip, Yngve Slyngstad. Nicolai Tangen called this the dream seminar, which it most definitely was. The trip started in two different locations, Oslo and London Stansted Airport. From Oslo, participants traveled in a large Airbus plane, done up entirely as business class. Passengers at London Stansted Airport boarded the Crystal Sky, described as the world's newest and most spacious luxury jet. This jet is a Boeing 777, modified to contain a restaurant for 20 people, a chef, butlers, 2 wine bars, and spacious bathrooms, plus seats that can recline into beds, furnished with 24-inch televisions. Fredrik Sejersted, a government lawyer, described the journey to Norwegian tabloid Verdensgang as a luxurious crossing and most unusual for the participants. Knut Brundtland, an art collector, said that guests were invited to attend with all expenses paid, something he noted was exceptionally generous, which can be confirmed by the price tag of these flights. You see, Tangen paid a total of $1.2 million for these 2 flights alone. But the participants had much more waiting for them. Tangen had also arranged a concert by Sting that he paid $1 million for. The program was filled with speeches from all the participants, but the program also included some words written by Tangen himself. He wrote, "You are all exceptional. You all want to extend your range and open your minds. But like me, you may not always have sufficient time in your daily lives to do this. Which is why I have had to whisk you away to learn not only from some of the world's most inspiring speakers and professors, but also from each other." This might sound pure and a little strange, but there was one last thing written on the program. "You can't tell anyone about this trip." which is probably the reason why we didn't hear a single thing about this trip from any of the attendees before Tangen was announced as the new CEO of Norway's Oil Fund on March 26, 2020. This day also marked the beginning of official after official apologizing for not giving proper declarations to the public about attending this seminar. The former Minister of Trade and Industry in the government said, "I should have been more open about his decision to go to this dream seminar." However, the most scrutinized official that attended this event was Lyngstad, and for good reasons. It was his job that Tangen took through this carefully planned out bribery event. Lyngstad and Tangen got so much backlash from the Norwegian public and the press that it eventually led to the Oil Fund being forced to investigate Lyngstad's trip to this dream seminar, revealing he had slept and eaten at the conference at Tangen's expense, as well as taking the plane home that was chartered by Tangen from Philadelphia to Oslo. Out of convenience, he said. Lyngstad also revealed that he had attended the seminar in his professional capacity as head of the Oil Fund and that he spoke about his resignation at the event. However, he did not personally encourage Tangen to apply for the job. At least, that's what he said to the public. But emails requested by Dagens Næringsliv, a Norwegian newspaper, on April 3rd, reveal that the two men had been in contact from August 2016, and that this contact had dwindled away in 2020, when Lyngstad suddenly stopped responding to Tangen's emails. The only time since then Lyngstad had messaged Tangen back was when he congratulated him when he was announced as the new CEO of Norway's Oil Fund, which made it clear that something wasn't adding up, and that Tangen, as well as Lyngstad, had this in the works prior to Lyngstad's resignation as CEO of the Oil Fund. This is why the 15 members of Norges Bank Supervisory Council repeatedly wrote to the central bank for more details about Tangen's appointment as CEO, as they, along with the Norwegian people, knew there was more to this story. And on April 23rd, the council had enough and sent 26 questions detailing problematic aspects of the appointment and demanded a full written account from Norway's central bank. Just a week later, Norway's central bank responded with an 83-page document addressing all of these questions. And while most of it was just them trying their best to justify hiring Tangen as the new CEO by explaining his competence in the financial field, there were two things in particular they couldn't justify or explain. The first was the fact they didn't have Tangen on the list of potential candidates, so they admitted it was wrong not to have him on it. However, they still tried their best to explain why they didn't, and the reasons were pretty weak. So weak, in fact, that it was basically a waste of time, even reading them. The only thing it did was solidifying the Norwegian people's concerns with this whole situation. But it only got worse the further down I went in the document, as the second thing they couldn't justify was the fact that Yngve Lyngstad went to the Dream Seminar, paid for entirely by Tangen. So what they ended up doing was taking the Norwegians' taxpayer money and covering Yngve Lyngstad's expenses on that trip. Basically meaning they paid Tangen for his troubles of successfully bribing the CEO of Norway's Oil Fund. And while it is clear that Tangen has successfully taken the position as CEO, no one has figured out why he wanted that position in the first place, considering the salary at Norway's Oil Fund amounts to just $630,000, a mere 0.001% of his total net worth. Which means that this was not for financial reasons. So what was it? Did he want to erase his past and do something good for the nation he was born in? Or did it have to do with a desire to have more power? And when you think about it, the answer isn't that difficult to find. You see, once you have wealth, there's only one thing left on the bucket list you need to achieve. And that is power. And considering Norway's Oil Fund is the largest in the world and owns around 1.5% of the entire stock market, it's clear that Tangen couldn't have found a more powerful position to be in. But there is one last thing that concerns me. You see, I mentioned earlier that Norway was trying to stray away from companies located in tax havens, which is not something Tangen seems to be too worried about continuing. VG asked him what he thought about having invested heavily in tax havens like the Cayman Islands and Jersey, given he was about to take the top job at a fund that has been striving for tax transparency and cracking down on the use of tax havens. To which he answered, well, everyone's doing it. Not really the thing you want to hear from the CEO of the world's largest sovereign wealth fund. This is probably why the oil fund hasn't decreased its investments in tax havens since he got appointed. And considering he has many more years left, it makes the future very uncertain. But what is certain is that only a small percentage of people who watch these videos are actually subscribed. So, if you ended up liking this video, consider subscribing, it's free, and you can always change your mind.